رب العالمين نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا اشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله امام المرسلين خاتم النبيين ارسله الله الى الناس كافه بدين الحق صلى الله تعالى عليه وعليه واصحابه ومن تبعهم باحسان الى يوم الدين امين All praise due to Allah, who created good and evil, and commanded us to do good deeds, and promised to reward good with good, and Allah forbidden all evils, and promised to punish all evil doers. We praise Allah, the compassionate, the merciful. We seek Allah's help and His assistance. We also seek Allah's forgiveness. May He forgive us our past sins. I bear witness that Allah is one. He has no partner nor associate, no even assistant. I also bear witness that Muhammad is His messenger and His apostle. Allah sent him as a giver of glad tidings and a warner ahead of the day of judgment. The peace and blessing of Allah be upon him, his households, his companions, and whoever followed their footsteps up to the day of judgment. Amen. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, let it be my topic. What is next after Ramadan? Ramadan has come and gone. It came so quickly. When Ramadan was approaching, we said, oh, when did we did one Ramadan? As if it was 3 or 4 months ago. That was Ramadan 2014. But Ramadan came, and when it's getting to the end of it, it seems to us as if we don't want to part with it. And that is life. No matter how sweet, we should remember that nothing will stay for forever, even inclusive our life. I remember Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a day used to make warning to us. We can't hear because a day is talking to us all the time. And then we say, oh, my brother, the owner of the land will call him. We say, look, I'm here since morning. I've been here. And very shortly, I will part with you. And after today, I will never come back again until the day of judgment. So that day is gone. So related to the Ramadan that passes now, that Ramadan will never come to be again. Yes, there will be another Ramadan. If Allah so will and give us long life, we can witness many. Even when we want to witness thousands, it is possible. If Allah restore our life. But don't forget the fact that there are people that witnessed last Ramadan, that's Ramadan 2014 with us. But before Ramadan 2015, they are not anymore. What have we done to God? Why? How do you feel, how do you mean that Allah decides who is to remain and who not to? Brothers and sisters, let us remember, the days go quickly. It's not even day, months. Years is going just like months now. And that is ringing a bell. That Ramadan has passed. All the lessons we learned in the month of Ramadan, we should not allow it to be washed away. We should not allow it to be washed away. Therefore, brothers and sisters, we recently lived the blessed month of Ramadan. It's fragrant night, a night that we love than any other thing. People will be running. They have forgotten that Tarawih is just a sunnah. It's not farmed. It will seem that even though when they don't pray Tarawih prayer, they don't have fasting. No, it is an extra good deed that Allah promised that whoever does extra good deed will be rewarded by it. But let us remember it's pregnant night, the month of the Holy Quran, the month of Taqwa, and the month of freedom, because Allah is not allowing shaitan to have freedom during the month of Ramadan. Rasulullah SAW said, Allah has chained shaitan in the month of Ramadan. So whoever does evil in the month of Ramadan only wishes to do evil by himself. And we have nobody to be blamed. Because you see a lot of people who are ready to do good. What will you say? What excuses? Probably your excuses will be many one. The one that will be watered away will not be heard. Dear Muslim, it is the right time to look back and see what we have gained in the month that passed, ended yesterday. What have we gained? We love to say, to pray. We love to read the Quran. We associate ourselves, our hearts is fully in the mosque. I can bet. How then you will find somebody that is not spending up to 8 hours in the masjid in every day of Ramadan? But now, maybe five, if you pray 5 times daily in the masjid, it will be 5 times 5, which is 25. At most, 10 times 5, that will be less than an hour. And remember, every day we spend 12 hours, 8 hours, 6 hours, especially when we come at night for Tarawih. Now you want to drop all these brothers and sisters. You quickly want to forget. And that is why now we should talk about it. We should talk about it to see what we can do. Ramadan to Ramadan. You see, we have so many blessings. We should not allow these blessings to go by us. We should hold them. Let us keep all the extra reward. How should we do that? Even though you don't have 6 hours, we can understand. A lot of you took the old man for holiday to be able to do extra good deeds. Yes, you don't have that time. But try. Try, get out of only 5 minutes per hour, per one salat. That is less than 1 hour in a day. Out of 24 hours, you will not be able to explain this. Dear Muslims, Ramadan is gone. Ramadan should be seen in many ways. Men living the 5 times prayer in congregation. We should not forget. Some people will not even come on that Friday. Some people will not even, they don't have time in the morning. But throughout Ramadan, they cannot, because we cannot even sleep in summer. Your Tarawih is getting you little minutes from Zuhur. Then you wake up to go to the masjid and come back before you rest a bit. Going to the mosque for sunnah prayer, living obligatory ones. People enjoyed it. Returning to your evil habits before Ramadan. The smokers are saying it. Some of them are very bad smokers. In the month of Ramadan, you fear Allah and the one that you want. But the minute the Ramadan is gone, it started again. If you can leave something for 1 month I do not see reason why you should not believe it forever. Ah, I cannot do without drinking. I'm not of things to drink apart from alcohol. The time you don't have money to drink, you will do without drinking. If you beg today, you beg tomorrow, you won't be able, you won't find anybody to beg again. Ah, you don't have me to pay money for your meter, nothing. You want me to pay for your drinking. Even though it's a drunkard, you will not pay it. Then you will learn how to restrain yourself from drinking, maybe one in a month. Brothers and sisters, nobody is perfect. Nobody is perfect. We are all wrongdoers. But the best among us, he is the one that when you wrong yourself, you can't wrong Allah. Don't do this. It's not because of Allah, it's because of ourselves. Don't do that. Don't commit sinner. Allah has no wife. He has no daughters. He has no sisters. So you will not fear whether you commit sinner with any of his relation, because he has no one. You, that you believe in Allah, you are the relation to Allah. Returning to evil habits, the habits you have chosen to do before Ramadan, and Ramadan is coming, you stop it. Brothers and sisters, is an advice that you don't go back to them. Muslim must at any time be in the state of obedience to Allah. You cleansing yourself. And remember all good deeds. That's why we continue thanking you. That we thank you for your support. Everything. If you want to sweep now, we will stand up and do it. Even without any sweeper, anything. They will pick the mosque. If you want to use certain money, you will give it out. When we ask for appeal, you donate it, you do well. When you say somebody needs something, you do it. But don't keep this. Don't keep away of this. Continue to do this. Don't forget all your charity of Ramadan. Spending money does not reduce your wealth. It's cleansing two things in you. It's cleansing the remaining money you have. Also, it's cleansing your heart that I've decided to take 1,000 out of 40,000. We are greedy. 2.5% of 40,000 is 1.40. Of 40,000 is 1,000. If you are greedy not to pay 1,000 out of 40, and that's 39 remaining, will not reduce, it will be increased by the grace of Allah. Allah can manifold, he can thanks it to any amount he wants. Maybe by next year, before you are due to pay another tithe, maybe you have got 200,000 in that account without stealing. You don't necessarily have to steal. When you have to have it, you will have it. Even when you steal, if you don't have to have it, you will steal, you won't have it. Brothers and sisters, all our good things like sadaqah, like zakat, some people choose Ramadan to be the month that they have to give out their zakat. Ramadan remind them that, oh, Ramadan is coming, I have to pay my zakat. How much have I had? How much is it? As of now, how much is my own savings? Then pay zakat. So, may God bless Allah. Make us one that will keep on with all good deeds of Ramadan. And brothers and sisters, Allah says in Surah Az-Zariyah, verse 55, when Allah said, فَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And that is why we don't wait until when we are forgotten about what we have done. If somebody cannot eat this afternoon, eating in the morning, you will not mind, because our body is still used to it, that we keep ourselves without eating. But if we leave it for 2, 3, 4 months, you will realize that you are completely out of the system of fasting. But now, if we remind ourselves of all good deeds that we did in the month of Ramadan, surely we will continue to get more, more and more reward. And at the end of the day, our mizan, our bucket, is a very full of good deeds. Let us remember, when Allah prescribed fasting in the month of Ramadan, why? We didn't fast for any reason to Allah. It has nothing to do with Allah. First and foremost, it keeps us fit. Look how healthy you are. Some people are just walking like this before Ramadan, but because they have to stand up and go down many, many times in the day, they become so healthy that you can jump all around. Brothers, this is one of benefits. Why did we fast? What to do after the fasting is gone? Reported by Muslim, the month of Ramadan has come and gone, and as if it has never come. It is one of the stations that comes once in a year. All our act of ibadah, Allah is great. Allah is great. He knows how He plans the things. There are more that believe that every second of our life, we must have to be a good moment. You have to have faith all the time, no condition you have. If you are sick, if you are healed, if you are healthy, if you are sad, you still have to deal with your iman, otherwise you are not a good believer. And another act, that is the first mode of iman, that is the first pillar of Islam. And pray 5 times a day. The next one is what you will do, not only one, not two, not three, not four, but 5 in a day, apart from sunnah. There are other ones, like Juma. Yes, it's part of our mode of our pillar of Islam, yes? But you still have to do it once. Juma is once in a week. You see how Islam break it, how Allah break it in Islam. Everything is beautiful. Allah did not create anything without any purpose. Even up to human being, we are created for a purpose, not just for a jest or for nothingness. And the purpose of our creation is to worship and do the will of Allah, brothers and sisters. When you are created to do the will of Allah, and we are praying, the prayer of the day is 5, 10 minutes at least, making 50, less than 1 hour out of 24 hours. And that is the purpose we are created. But Allah has left the time that we work for what we will eat. We are working to eat. We are eating to live. We are living to worship Allah. It is one of the stations that comes once in a year. It is also a garden from gardens of paradise, where the Muslim enjoy the light of being close to Allah. Ramadan is a small draw of many masses of Allah. Allah sent Ramadan to us to be a masjid. From His masjid, from His rahmah, that no matter what condition you are, in the month of Ramadan, the chain have to be loosed on you. Why? Because Shaitan drives our head like he's steering of a car. But because Allah has chained Shaitan in the month of Ramadan, he has no will, no power, he's powerless. Ramadan is an institution which teaches us to be patient in the obedience of Allah. You see, you will say Allah, 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 Allah. You said you ask me and you've gone. Even ask me, I've no number after the sign. But when is Maghrib? Allah, 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 3 times, he's gone. But in Ramadan, this time by eat. Even we have not broken our fast. We have just eaten fruit or dates. We finish Maghrib. Instead of rushing to go and eat, we take our time to do sunnah. Why? Because we know we benefit from it. And nobody tells you that you have no benefit, even after Ramadan. So, they are Muslims. Ramadan is gone, but all other mode of worship remain. Our life consists of days and nights, hours and minutes. Not a single day goes by without saying to you, I am witnessing to what you did. Oh, my friend, I'm going. Today will be telling us, in another few hours, 2-3 hours, he'll be telling us, we heard, because we knew the day is going, even summer is deceiving us. But even summer, when the light is still on at 9 o'clock, we know the night, I mean, the day is gone. Suddenly, when that night crossed, we will just see the darkness. So we know, out of 24 hours, we have spent 9 plus 12. That is 21. That's 9 o'clock in the night. So you have remaining hours, a few hours to go and sleep. We need to watch it. And this is the time, brothers and sisters, to look at it. Allah bless Muslims by giving us all these stations of worshiping. Look at mosque. You will not walk more than Tesco and return before you find another mosque. That is very clear. If you are not using to hear, go to another mosque. We are not just like other believers. That if they are Muslim association, they must have to be a Muslim association before they worship their Lord. If they are Oaken Road, you must have to be Oaken Road before you worship your Lord. No, at work. Eh? When you are walking near to Goody Street, you go to the mosque there. Go to Central Agaga. You will see other friends. That is Islam. Islam is a peaceful religion. Brothers and sisters, fast bring passion under control. Fast in the month of Ramadan or any time. You see, you won't have control. You will manage the time and the availabilities you have. You won't do things as your own wish. And that is the best of Islam. And if you control your passion, as passion is the root of all evil, so it means you won't be able to do any evil and can be regulated by abstaining from God's desire. It purifies the soul and makes it sublime. Your soul will not, in Ramadan, you won't see bad things. Even though they are going at your reach, you will just cover as if you don't see. You neglect it. I remember many years ago, during Ramadan, if you go to Edward Road, you will see those youths expected to be fasting. They will take their kataban around them. They are smoking. You just pass as if you don't see them. What concern does that have to do with you? What do you mean by that? That is what he has chosen to do. But you have chosen to be a mu'min, somebody that Allah will say, do this, and we do it. It commands concentration in prayer. We have time in Ramadan to settle in our prayer. We sit, we rest in sitting before we go to sujood again. It checks false notion of pride and prestige. How then you see somebody who walk arrogantly in the month of you don't even have stamina to walk arrogantly in the month of Ramadan. Kill. I mean, disturbing the whole world as if you are the creator of your heart. You don't create anything. You make things. The carpenter made this by wood. It's not the creator of the wood. But Allah created this wood. Without wood, he cannot make this. But Allah made us from nothing. He created us from nothingness, from no object, object of anybody, but he created it. So you have to check your false notion. Don't tell. In one chapter, Allah said, "Down to God, the other can reveal." Allah will crush, will be crushed with anybody who loves to tell lies. And he that is feeling arrogant because it's the garment of Allah, he doesn't want anybody to wear it alone or the same time or any time with him. It greatly contributes to the preservation of health, as I told you, going up and down. It accustoms a man to face the hardship of life, any difficulties in Ramadan. Hey, I'm happy we have in Ramadan, even though I don't have money. Because I can go to Central Box and go and bring my car, and I will take enough to heat and shahu. They won't know. But now if you go there, you have to pay money before you eat. The life goes in the month of Ramadan. It increases the power of endurance. You are more patient in Ramadan. It also has a social value. It gives a mass movement towards equality. You will feel the same. In Ramadan, you eat together, you sit down together, you pray together, you do everything together. You don't have to meet others. You manage to be here. One part of the world that affects all Muslims. You see, we are feeling what other countries are feeling, as if we are in that country. Boko Haram in Nigeria, everybody feels. Not only Nigeria. No Nigerian feel most than us. Because they know the value of life. We should not kill the life we cannot create. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the day of judgment, he said, "Yati ayom yukallahu yawm al-akhir yawm al-qiyam." The day is coming. What account? We're just going to 3 o'clock plus 12, 15 hours out of today. We cannot take our material, writing materials, and account for 15 hours since 12 midnight. We can't. By the time we say Zul, we sleep, we wake up, we don't know. We went to the park, went to eat. What do you do with the remaining hours? That is why it is better daily, a reasonable Muslim, a woman, before going, putting his feet on the bed. Sit down, put your feet on the ground, and look at what you have done today. Oh, I've done this. I'm not supposed to have done this. Take it out. Pray on it. Allah, I don't want this. I don't want to do it again. Please, be merciful. Forgive me. May Allah forgive each and every one of us. Are you announced? Our Yom Eid, as we know today, is the day of Eid. Yom Tahlil, the day that we praise the name of Allah. Takbir. Allah. I'm only saying the day of Takbir. Allahu Akbar. Even though you don't say Allahu Akbar, Allah is Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Fauka kaidilehu. Allah is greater than everything. So whether you say it is Akbar or not, we are deceiving ourselves. But if you say it, Allah is happy. It's just as if they are saying, "Oh, you are from this place, that the mercy of God." Then you will be feeling very healthy. But Allah feels very happy when you say Allahu Akbar. He knows it's Akbar. When you say Alhamdulillah, I give thanks to you. He's very happy. Allah thank himself. In Surah Al-Fatiha, first chapter of the Holy Quran, he said, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. I thank myself. That's what Allah says. He didn't say, "Oh, you Rasulullah." Say, Alhamdulillah. There is no command there. Allah started, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. in the name of Allah, Alhamdulillah, I thank Allah. Allah is thanking Allah. Rabbul Alameen, the creator and the sustainer of the whole universe. He created the world of the fish in the ocean. He created humankind in this planet. Don't you see, 9 years, they send a program to go and see other planets. They want to be living where Allah is not asking them to go. I don't know, but that is where technology is coming. Google Web, that Quantum will wear everything in our pocket. They don't have to check anything before they say it. So it is now we plan to be good ones. They will check our mind. After me, they do operation of heart. So they don't need to break anybody, any part of the body before they do operation now. They will see it, what is troubling you, and they will remove it with little hope. The time is coming, they will command it through the computer. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. But yet, they will not be able to do it. They will create it. They will be looking for blood of Allah to give me a blood if I'm short of. I don't pray to be short of blood. May Allah give us good health. They can, why is it they can't produce? They can produce juice. Juice cannot produce enough blood that I need. It's only Allah. And you know how many times our heart beats in a day. Don't let me count it, because we won't live here. If you stop once, voila, to the hospital. Don't we thank God? Alhamdulillah, today is the day of reminding that Allah is the powerful. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Let me remind you before going down for the second part of my khutbah. The prayer, remember the beautiful. The beautiful, one beautiful thing in Ramadan that you don't see in any other day. Of the other 11 months, you won't find it. That is lying down to the country. Don't go through the ministry because you had it. You had it a few days ago. Lying down to the country, a khayru min alf shahr, better than 80 days. You walk, you manage to find that day, and you walk righteous on that day. It's as if you walk righteously for 80 years. Takbir. So that is what you want to put in the bill. Until next year, let me remind you, many other people that we fast tent together last year, they are not alive to fast this year. Are we sure? Because we live today, there's no guarantee that we live tomorrow. A moment should think as life can expire at any time. When it expires, nobody can renew it. Brothers and sisters, let us bear in mind. You stay along with me. Allahumma. Innaka afuwwun. Tuhibbu al-afwa. Fa'fu 'anna. Allahumma. Innaka afuwwun. Tuhibbu al-afwa. Fa'fu 'anna. Allahumma. Innaka afuwwun. تحب العفو خاف ولا هو الله forgive us our sin استغفر ربك لو كان الخاف we ask him to bless Prophet Muhammad his households his companions and whoever among us follow his footsteps until the day of judgment. I also want us to rejoice in our hope and assurances of the blessing of that loyalty country. May Allah bless us. Amen. Brothers and sisters, hadith of the Prophet said, he who observed the fasting of Ramadan and then fast 6 in the month of Shawwal, that is the month that starts today, would be as if he or she had fasted for the whole year. You know the account of it. All the time we have. Rasulullah is not to be a dear older. But Allah blessed him. The message Allah gave him warrants him to have knowledge. Rasulullah will talk as if he knows. And what Rasulullah cannot know is the past and the future. But Allah told him about the past and guided him for the future. So Rasulullah was cleansing of any ambiguities. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us not forget the needy people in our community. After zakat al-fitr is given to them, it's not only in Ramadan we should be doing good. If you see anybody, I don't say you should suggest that because the way I'm working, I may not be eating, I may be able to eat. But if you see somebody, even if it's holding a card, some people say, no, I'll give you money, we'll go and drink. Somebody say he has drunk enough, but he has nothing to eat. And he wants him to die. He may come back and accept Islam. Make sure the money I'm giving to you, I don't have much. But I will give you enough to go and eat. Make sure you eat with it. You have done your own. In fact, Allah will count the reward. We multiply it for you. That you have passion, you have mercy. And whoever have mercy, don't you want Allah to be merciful to forgive you? Why don't you forgive others? That's a very interesting hadith. Rasulullah said, you want Allah to forgive you. And somebody comes to you and says, please, I made a mistake, forgive me, I won't do it again. And you arrogantly feel somehow. But the only thing is, Allah said, I won't forgive anybody that is not repenting. If you commit a sin, you don't repent, you continue committing it. But if you forgive, if you ask for forgiveness, I will come to you and say, what is it that I've done that is wrong? If you tell me, I won't be able to do it again. But you see everybody that can do that? No, arrogantly. We do wrong things for two purposes. One, maybe ignorantly. Two, maybe arrogantly. And the two ways have a punishable part on the day of account. May He not punish us. We pray that we don't do evil. Because Allah promised to punish the evil doer. He is the Lord who has the power to do and undo. Let us not disconnect ourselves from the Holy Quran and other things that we do in the month of Ramadan. Finally, my advice to you is peace. Peace. Peace is the only thing we need. We cannot get peace unless we love ourselves. If we love ourselves, peace will reign. Because I love, something is there, I don't see there. You see, that's love. If you don't love it, you will neglect as if you don't see. But Allah will reward you. Yes. If Allah wants to save you, He will save you without me telling you. But if we love ourselves, that will change your mind towards my action. Salami saw me wanting to sit down on that nail, and he said it to me. If I were him, I wouldn't tell him. Oh, it should be good. That is why it's good to be good. We pray to Almighty Allah to make us good Muslims. We pray for the peace. We pray for the peace. We are lack of peace in the whole world. Not only in Nigeria, everywhere. Everywhere. We need peace. And until we turn to Allah, until we do the will of Allah, we will just be seeing what we are seeing. May Almighty Allah help us and let us have peace. ربنا وفقنا وفقنا وحمنا رمضان فانظرنا إلى هذا القوم الكافرين ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم إجعل ما نشاء موافقا ما تشاء كي لا يصل ما نشاء مخالفا ما تشاء وما نعمل العبد ما لا يشاء الله جعل العبد وشاء من كان ما يشاء الله رب العالمين Brothers and sisters, we pray that may Allah make us to witness many Ramadan. I say, Eid Mubarak.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن